Hi, I'm Danny. Welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to diagnose the immobilizer system in my 2009 Honda Civic. My immobilizer system has been causing me problems for about 2 years now. It's intermittent and it only happens about once every 3 months. It'll start up, it'll die, and if I shut the key off, turn it back on, it'll run. So I've never really been worried about it. Today, it actually happened into the garage and it's not starting as of now. If you're not sure you have this system, turn the key on and you should see that green key come on just for a second. Let's do that again. And there it was. If you're not familiar with the immobilizer system, it's a theft deterrent device that's built into the vehicle to prevent the vehicle from starting, unless the correct program key is used. Let me show you what my vehicle's doing and how I'm gonna diagnose this issue. So I got the key and I'm gonna start it as normal. This time it just stopped. Let me start it again. And now it won't start at all. But if you look, my green light's flashing. And if I pull the key out, it's still flashing. Now if I use a different key, starts up again and it works just fine. So now I know it's got something to do with the key. So this is how the system works. When the transponder key is inserted into the ignition and turned on, the immobilizer control unit sends a signal to the transponder key. The transponder key sends back a coded signal to the immobilizer control unit, which sends a coded signal to the ECM and the MICA module. If everything matches, your vehicle starts. If not, it disables the fuel. All right, so I've got the key. I'm gonna go ahead and just take this apart. And while it's apart, I'm gonna clean it with some electronics cleaner. And I'm gonna check the battery for the remote because the remote seems to be a little bit slow when I push them buttons. I like to get a washcloth and just lay it down. That way when I take these little tiny screws and parts out, they don't roll off my bench. So let's get started and get this apart. It's gonna take a couple of really tiny screwdrivers. All right, so there's that tiny little screw. You can barely see it. I'm gonna put that right here. And if you looked here, there's like a little tab right there. So if you can get your finger in there, that's better. Otherwise you can use like a little screwdriver. Pulled it out. And then here it is. So it clicks back here, clicks on. And then right here, here's your module right there. So let's go ahead and pop the module out. And that's what that looks like here. And then from here, just take another screwdriver. And you're gonna pull that tab off. And pull that tab off. So here's this. This is all your door locks. And this little gadget right there, that's your battery. By the way, the battery doesn't have anything to do with the transponder. It's for the keyless remote. And I wanna check my battery. There we go. That's kinda all I need is that. And then we're gonna check our battery. Put one there. And one there, and we got 3 volts. So the battery actually checks out good. I don't think I need to go get a new battery. It's a 3-volt battery, so I'm just gonna leave that battery as is. And I'm gonna clean up all this housing and this with some electronics cleaner and a Q-tip. All right, so I've got my Q-tip, and even though this is electronic safe, I'm gonna actually just be real careful. I'm just cleaning everything up just to make sure all the contacts work, and there's no extra dirt. I've got it apart, I might as well clean it up. All right, so I've got it all cleaned up. Looks pretty good. And now the battery. So the battery, the area with the number on it here, that goes down, because that's the plus side. If your keyless remote needs a battery, it's a 3-volt DL1616 Duracell. These are easily found on Amazon or any store that sells batteries. Take this and this tab. Comes over here. Just make sure it's all snapped in. Then we'll take our key. Just line it up. And then our cover. Cover is just gonna be this side first. Snaps in, and then our tiny, tiny screw. So if you made it this far in the video, if you could just hit that subscribe button, I would appreciate it. As you can see, it's reading, it's working. All right, so with our scan tool, let's check the control module. And we have no codes there, so let me go back. And let's find the immobilizer. All right, immobilizer unit. The module's not supported. So I guess I can't get any codes on that one. All right, so, but it does work. I hope you got something out of today's video. I feel like I fixed it, but not really, because it's so intermittent. I probably won't know for a couple of more months, but at this point, I'll stop my diagnosis because there's not a whole lot of information out there on intermittent problems like this. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up, consider subscribing. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.